Hello class 2, this is your English literature class. How are you? I think you all are fine. Children, today we will do page number 32 of your book. This is your book New Mulberry Part 2, isn't it? And in this book we are doing chapter 2. And in chapter 2 we have completed the explanation of the story. Then I have sent the PDF file of all the question answers, that is page number 30 and 31. So you have to check the PDF, you will get this, all the question answers done, and please do write in the CW copy. This part also I have given for you, I have written and I have sent for you. So children, all of you write this in your CW copy and send it for correction. Now today we will do page number 32. So all of you take out your book and open your book at page number 3 to 32. Okay, see 32 and 33, this is chapter 2. Okay, now here in this chapter, in this exercise, in this page, we will see the use of a and the. Okay, use of a and the. Where do we have to use a, n, and the? Okay, so we use a, n, and the before naming words or before nouns, isn't it? All of us, we know this, before countable nouns. Okay, we use a and n. Suppose this is, I have one pen. Then what I'll write? I have a pen. Means I have one pen, isn't it? And we all know that we use an before the naming word, before the noun that begins with a vowel sound. Like vowels are A, E, I, O, U. Okay, so these are vowels. And any word, any noun that begins with A, E, I, O, U, before those noun we put N. Suppose apple, an apple. E for suppose A, then N-A. I for give a right. Any word ink, an ink, isn't it? So O for ox, an ox. Then U, umbrella, an umbrella. So whatever we write N before the, we use N before the name, before the naming word or before the noun that begins with vowels. These are called vowels. These are called vowels. And rest are consonant. And before the consonant, we use a. Isn't it? Suppose boy, a boy. Because B is consonant. There are 26 letters in English language. Isn't it? And among these 5 are vowels and the rest are consonants. Isn't it? Now here, we will learn where do we use a and where we have to use an and where to use the. Okay, and this thing, these articles, and they are called, these three together, they are called articles. Articles. And you will learn more about this in your language class. Okay, in your language class you will learn in detail about this. Clear? Now see children, here few sentences are given. With the help of the sentences, I will make you clear. Okay, you will be clear about where to use a and where to use an and where to use the. Okay. Now see first sentence. A merchant lost a purse. Okay, a merchant lost a purse. It may be any purse. Okay. A merchant lost a purse. Number two. A woman found the purse. The purse. Next one, number three. The woman gave the purse to the merchant. The woman gave the purse. The purse. Then to the merchant. So here one more thing I have to write a merchant. Because in the first step line it is given that a merchant lost a purse. Okay. Now here children see a merchant. We are not sure of who is the merchant. Merchant's name was not written. So we have written a merchant. A merchant lost a purse. This a merchant and a purse. Okay. Because here we are not particularly mentioning the name of the merchant or which purse. We are not definite about this. Isn't it? It may be any merchant, any purse. But in the second sentence, we said the woman found the purse. The woman found here the purse. Yes, here a purse and here the purse. Why now we are clear that we are definite about which purse the woman found? The woman found the purse that was lost by that merchant. That was lost by that merchant. Now we are sure about that purse. We are talking about that particular purse which was lost. Okay. So here before purse we are writing the. Here we are definite about. We are talking particular about that purse. So here the purse. See in the next line. The woman gave the purse to the merchant. Now the woman, and in the first line, in the second line you found a woman. When we are talking about any woman, we said a woman. But in the third line, what we have found? The woman. Why the woman here? Why a woman in the first sentence? The woman here because we are talking particularly about that woman. We are particular, we are definite about it. Okay, I'll tell you afterward. So we have what is definite and what is indefinite. What is definite and what is indefinite article? I'll tell you. Just listen properly. Now in the third line I say the woman gave the purse to the merchant. Now when I'm saying this word means we are particularly, we are specific towards a particular woman, a particular purse and a particular merchant. Here the woman means the woman who has found the purse. And purse means the purse here refers to the purse that was lost. Definite here also. Then the merchant. Here in the third line the merchant because we are talking about that particular merchant who has lost his purse. So what we have found? We have found that there are two kinds of articles. One is definite article, another one is indefinite article. When we talk about definite article's example is the. The is definite article and a and an, they are indefinite article. Why the is definite article? Because now we know about the particular person. We are specific. When we are specific about some noun or some object, then we use the. So what we have found? We have found that there are two kinds of articles. There are two. Articles are divided into two parts. Articles. So number one, indefinite. And number two, definite. Okay, now indefinite means we are not sure about, we are not specific about that person. It may be any man, any woman. When we are not definite or when we are not talking about a particular person, isn't it? Now when we are indefinite, we talk an apple, give me an apple. It may be any apple, isn't it? Then we say an apple. Now if I say give me the apple that you have brought yesterday, I'm talking about a particular, talking about the apple for which you have brought yesterday. Now I am definite, so I say the apple. Understood? This is the difference between definite article and indefinite article. Okay, Now see, example of indefinite articles are a, an, and definite article is the. If I say I have a book, I have a storybook, I have a storybook, fine. Now when I say give me the storybook you have bought today or you are talking about. Now I am talking about yesterday, you might have told me I have a storybook and now I want that particular storybook. So I said give me the storybook that you are talking about yesterday, about which you are talking to me, about which you told me. So give me that particular book. So here when I say a book, it may be any book. When I say the, definite means that particular book. Clear? So this is the difference between definite article and indefinite article. Children, have you understood? Try to go through this, listen not only for one time. If you are not understanding, try to go through the video twice or thrice with the examples, then we'll be able to understand. See, here a picture is given. See, I'll read the picture for you. A boy, you can see a boy, a dog, a monkey, isn't it? See, the boy is saying, I have a dog, the dog is smart. Now the boy is saying, I have a dog. Here, he is talking about a dog, not particular. Now he is saying, the dog is smart. Now the dog which I have is smart. So here we have written the dog because I am talking about the dog that the boy has. Okay. Now see here, I have bananas, the banana is sweet. See the monkey, I think the monkey is saying I have a banana, I have a banana. Okay, any banana, not that big banana or the small banana, thick banana. Okay, just I have a banana. Now say the banana is sweet. I'm talking about that particular banana that I have. So here in the next sentence we have written the banana. Clear? Is it clear to you that the difference between where to use definite article and where to use indefinite article? So we use a and an before naming word that we can count. As I told you earlier, a and an shows us one person, one place, one animal, one student, isn't it? An ant means one ant. Understood? An egg means one egg. An elephant, one elephant. And we use an before words that begins with the vowel sound that I have told you. We use an before the noun that begins with vowel sound. Okay. And here you can see in the picture, this is a rail, isn't it? So, see, all these are A, E, I, O, U. They are known as vowels. Okay, and rest of the letters, see, B, C, D, F, G, H, all these are consonants. Okay, so now in the next class, we will do the exercise given in page number 33. By that time, please go on what I have taught you today. Thank you.